buying. Joining us now is Siddharth Mohanty, the MD and CEO of LIC Housing Finance. Mr. Mohanty, good morning. Thank you very much for joining us. First up, a very happy new year to you. May you have a great 2021. And let me start with the first business question as well. Was December really very good? Did you get to finance much more going by the registrations?
So, good morning, Lata. Thank you. Wish you a very, very happy new year.
Thank you.
To you, to entire team and all your viewers. If you see real estate sector, that was always grappling with two issues. One is liquidity, another is demand. But recently, we have observed these two issues have been addressed and a sufficient liquidity is there thanks to the initiatives taken by government and RBI. And now consumption demand has gone up. That's why last month here, Mumbai itself, 19,000 registration we have experienced. So that itself shows there is demand, because last year we were concerned with demand because due to poor demand, inventories were lying and all those issues. But now, thanks to all those issues developed post-COVID, everything is on track. So I foresee coming days, there will be still greater demand because everybody, all the constituents of this sector, they are on same page. So that creates confidence in the minds of the home buyers. End users are buying. Those who had earlier smaller apartment, they are going for bigger one. Even people are also going for investment apartment. And these growths are not pertaining to only seven metros. Our experience is even tier two, tier three cities where house is much affordable, there also we have seen very, very high growth.
Okay. Can you give us some numbers, sir? I mean, you told us about how growth is picking up quite a bit, but I want to understand from you on the disbursal front, what kind of growth do you see in the second half? So far in Q2, your disbursals were about 12,400 crores, which is a growth of just about 2%. What kind of growth rates do you expect in the second half?
You see, last two quarters, Q1 and Q2, Q1, you know, that was virtually nothing was there because April and May, we were having nothing, absolutely clueless. Everybody was clueless. June onwards, slightly it picked up, and Q2, we did good growth. Now, if you see, particularly our Q3, of course, results will be out by the end of this month. We are experiencing very, very high growth. And I am confident at the end of the year, we will close at least good double-digit growth over last year. That is my sense. The way things are moving every day, huge collection, huge disbursement is there. And our people are under pressure. They are sitting late night to complete all the proposals. So that indicates a good sign. So at the end of the year, you will find a double-digit growth for us.
That's so good to hear, Mr. Mohanty, considering that, you know, your AUM in the second quarter grew by what, 5%, and 5% disbursals were growing by 2%, 2.2 actually, in Q2. And Q2 will actually come out a little bit. In spite of it, you could do only 2.2. So hearing double digit sounds very good. But when you say double digit, you mean Q4 over Q4 double digit and Q3 over Q3 double digit? Or for full FY21 over FY20, yeah. Will you be at least flat or full year versus full year?
No, full year versus full year, double digit growth will be there.
Okay, because okay, good to hear that.
Observe last March, normally last week of the financial year, we experienced a 10% to 12% disbursement.
Right.
So that was totally not there, washed out too.
Got it.
So if you take that into account, definitely, because we are now showing some growth rate that is gradually increasing quarter after quarter. So at the end of the year, definitely double digit growth will be there.
Oh, that's very good to hear. Very good to hear. Well, what about bad loans? I mean, are you ultimately there will be some COVID casualties. What is your best guess of NPAs?
Our experience is people during, actually, you see, moratorium ended August.
Yes.
People who applied for moratorium, they have also started paying. They are paying regularly. Their accounts are up to date. But now my sense is many accounts, they are sitting on cash. They want to conserve their resource. All the facilities extended by government and regulators, somebody wants to avail that, to sit on the cash, because they still feel what will happen, they do not know. So they are waiting till the end of the year. So I don't find any deterioration in asset quality. Whatever was there, Q2, I think we'll maintain that, or we may improve. We have improved really last quarter. Some improvements have been made in good, big, big accounts.
Okay. So can you just give us a bit more details on where the improvements have been? Because you have a large chunk of your exposure to the corporate and builder loan accounts as well. Have you seen any significant recovery there, both in terms of lower delinquencies, better asset quality and disbursements too?
If you see, our total developer book is less than 7%. So within that, some accounts are there who apply for restructuring, and but they are still paying. So my sense is that it will not have much impact on our asset quality, though there will be some here and there, some deviation will be there, but it will not impact much.
Okay, Mr. Mohanty, finally, I wanted to ask you spreads and margins. Both of them showed a minor dip in FY20. FY21, will both be better?
Absolutely. You see, we are a triple A rated corporate, and we are raising fund at a very, very competitive rate. Recently, we have raised a tier 2,000 crore and adequately capitalized. Margin, you see, last two quarters, it has been reduced by 100 basis points cost of fund. So margin is stabilized, and in coming days, it will remain stable or it will improve. My sense is it will improve, because the way disbursements are happening, so there will be improvement in margin, though interest rate for the customer is competitive.
Yes, yes, he has got a lot of sources where he can get money, get home loans even below 7%. Thank you very much, Mr. Mohanty, for giving us a sense of how Q3 has panned out. And I think the best thing you told us is that you will reach double-digit growth. May you have a very good 2021.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right. Let's just wind this up by giving you the financials of the previous 3 years. As you noticed, Mr. Mohanty said that last year in FY20, they lost March. Otherwise, they would have done well. So you're important to keep that in mind. That will be an advantage for this year, because you'll have that low base impact. Nevertheless, it was a growth, as you can see in income. We will also get the other parameters up for you. Yeah, that's gross NPA. That's an unfortunate increase. And then you'll have the margins. See, margins showed a dip, but chances are it's going to do much better in 21, according to what Mr. Mohanty said, and that's flat in profit. All right, here's also a quick run through of the important changes that are going to be effective from this month. And this is perhaps the most important set of information that we're giving you. Let us start off with the set which comes into effect from today. RBI's positive pay system for cheques beyond 50,000 rupees comes into effect. This will aim to check banking frauds where customers will have to reconfirm key details for transactions above 50,000 rupees. RBI has allowed contactless card transactions limit to be raised to 5,000 from 2,000 rupees, which is the current norm. But that will be at the discretion of the user, and it will help UPI customers in making recurring payments like utility bills, investments, etc. The new RISCO meter for mutual funds is also going to be effective from today. Very important when you look at a mutual fund investment, go for the RISCO meter. It's a comprehensive set of rules which will now assess scheme level risk. Until now, you only got sector level risk. There is another important one. WhatsApp will remove support from older smartphone versions from the 15th of January. It will become mandatory to add zero before dialing a mobile number from a fixed phone. That's very important, but that's from 15th. On the 20th of this month, Twitter is set to announce a new account verification policy, which we commonly call the blue tick, and which was discontinued a while back. And finally, the deadline for mandatory fast tag payments, which was originally today, 1st of Jan, has been extended to 15th of February. I don't think it's a good idea, but anyway, that's the announcement. Okay, now we'll take a break and we're going to come back and we have a very important guest joining us, one of the star performers of 2020, Dr. Reddy's. G.V. Prasad, co-chairman, managing director of Dr. Reddy's, will be joining in to give us an outlook for 2021 and beyond.